Math 31, so we're going to take a look at equations in quadratic form. And this is going to be one of those topics where you probably have to give me a couple of examples for you to see the pattern, and then you'll start to be able to work the mechanics on your own. So go with me for examples 6 and 7, and then when we flip the page to example 8, hopefully you've picked up the pattern and be able to do it on your own. And we'll still practice them, obviously, but this is one of those where you just have to kind of watch me do it for a couple of examples, and then let me know what questions you have. And before we go into this, I'm just gonna do a little side problem because it's gonna play a role here. So I want you to think about x to the 1/3, okay? And then I want you to think about x to the 1/3, oops, squared. All right, ooh, that's not my best x. Let me put that in there. Now, we talked about this at the very beginning of the section. When you have a power raised to a power, you multiply the exponents. So I want you to think about 1/3 times 2, and that would be the fraction 2/3, right? It would have still a rational exponent, but it would be 2/3. So when I square x to the 1/3, I'm at x to the 2/3. Right? So I just want you to keep that in mind because that idea is going to play out when we do these equations in quadratic form. Okay, so again, give me a couple of examples and then we'll talk about the pattern and then we'll practice it in example 8. So an equation is said to be in quadratic form if it can be written as AU squared plus BU plus C. So the thing that we're changing out here is we don't have X's anymore. U is going to be some algebraic expression. And they talk about A not equaling 0 because, again, if A was equal to 0, then you'd have a linear equation, not a quadratic equation. So you're going to hear me refer to this idea as U substitution. And my guess is that for most of you, this might be the first time you're hearing that term. And depending on how far you need to go up the math chain, you might hear U substitution referred to in a calculus class. And that might seem like so far away, like, oh, calculus is like 2 semesters off. Okay, no problem. But I still want to introduce this idea of a U substitution. So we're going to consider this equation, right? Take a look at it. X plus 1, it's got a rational exponent of 2/3, minus x plus 1, rational exponent of 1/3, and then a minus 2. And we're going to try a couple of U substitutions. So we're going to rewrite this equation with 2 different U substitutions, just playing out in parts A and B. Now let me scoot this up a bit so that we can see all of that work that we're going to play out. Actually, let me scoot it up just a little bit further so we have all that room. So the first U substitution we're going to try is x plus 1, and then I'm going to try x plus 1 to the 1/3. And for examples 6 and 7, I will give you the U substitution, all right? And then we'll talk about the pattern and we'll practice it in example 8. So here we go. We're going to try letting u equal x plus 1. And when I do a u substitution, I'm going to rewrite this entire equation. You will not see the letter x anymore. You will only see the letter u. So let's try this. So if I was going to try this first suggested substitution of x plus 1, instead of x plus 1 to the 2/3, I can rewrite this part of the equation, this expression, as u to the 2/3, all right? And then instead of x plus 1 to the 1/3, I can say this is u to the 1/3. And now if you look at the minus 2, there is no x in it, so I have no substitution to make. That will just stay as a negative 2, and that's equal to 0. So all I have done is I have rewritten this original equation with u's using this particular u substitution, okay? And that's rewriting an equation using a u sub. It's not in quadratic form yet. We're going to get to that. We're working up to it. So now I want to use a better u substitution. All right, now again, I'm going to scoot this up just a little bit more so that I have enough room to have this play out. Now over here, I've got u equaling x plus 1 to the 1/3. And I want us to do some work here. All right, if u was equal to x plus 1 to the 1/3, I want you to square both sides and see what would happen. All right, so let me write this here. We're gonna square both sides. And you might be thinking like, Miss A, why are you having to square both sides? Why would I do that? And again, I go back to, you gotta watch me go through these examples a couple of times till you see the pattern. because what's going to happen is we're actually ultimately going to write this equation as a quadratic equation with u's right now, and I'll show you what I mean. So if I square both sides, I will have u squared here, and I will have x plus 1 to the 1/3 squared here, right? And we just talked about when you have a power raised to a power, you multiply the exponents. So x plus 1 to the 1/3 squared, if I'm continuing this, we will have that u squared is equal to x plus 1 to the 2/3. Because I will multiply 1/3 times 2 and get 2/3. So I have u equaling x plus 1 to the 1/3, and I have u squared equaling x plus 1 to the 2/3. So I want you to keep these terms in mind. So let's redo this equation. What can I write instead of x plus 1 to the 2/3? Well, I have a substitution to make, right? I know that's equal to u squared. All right, what can I write instead of x plus 1 to the 1/3? All right, I have another substitution. I'm being told that's equal to u. And then again, the 2, it has no x's in it, so I'm just going to write minus 2 equals 0. Well, this is a quadratic equation, and we have three ways of solving this quadratic equation, right? We've talked about it. I could factor, right? I could complete the square, or I could use the quadratic formula. And in example 8, we're gonna play all of that out. All right, so that will happen. It's just not going to happen right now. All I'm trying to get us in the habit of, or get us used to, is converting from whatever our original equation is, and how on earth do we get it into a quadratic equation? How do we get it in quadratic form using a u substitution? And I just want you to keep this in mind. So the u substitution that worked here was x plus 1 to the 1/3. This didn't quite get us into a quadratic equation, because you can see I still have fractional exponents, right? Still have those rational exponents, but here I had nice integers, okay? All right, so with that, let's try another one in example 7, and then we're gonna talk about the pattern that we're seeing, okay? I'll see you in a few, bye.